Hi guys. Today we're going to be talking more about non-essential elements versus essential elements. And in our very last lesson, which was about appositives, we talked about this a little bit. And when we talked about adjective clauses, we talked about it a little bit more. Let me show you a couple. I know you guys just did the appositive lesson, so we're not going to review that. But let me show you a couple of adjective clauses. One of them is essential and one of them is non-essential. This one says, "The book that I checked out yesterday is really interesting so far." So this one, if you just said, "The book is really interesting so far," nobody would know what you were talking about. So this clause right here, "that I checked out yesterday," it is an essential clause so that we know which book is being spoken of, okay? Because it's essential, there aren't any commas, okay? And then if we look down here, it says, "A separate piece, which I checked out yesterday, is really interesting so far." So here we know the name of the book, "A Separate Piece," okay? So if you tell a little bit more about the book, it's not necessary, it's just adding interest. That is why "which I checked out yesterday" has commas around it. Can you see them in this example, okay? So if you need it to know what you're talking about, there aren't any commas around the clause. If you don't need it to know what you're talking about, there are commas. It's just adding interest, okay? So this is just a little review of the adjective clause, whether they're essential or non-essential. And in a second, I'm going to show you guys about some participles, okay? Don't take any sections of the quiz. There's only one section in this quiz coming up, so wait until the end of the video to take that one, okay? Okay, now I want to show you guys some participles and how to know whether they are essential or non-essential in a sentence. So a participle is just, it looks like a verb, it's usually a verb, but it's being used as an adjective in the sentence, okay? You might say, if you said the toast burnt, you'd be saying that the toast did something, right? It burnt. But if you say the burnt toast, it's like a verb, only it's being used as an adjective. So you can see how these work here. Look at this, okay? It says, "All of the books shipped by Amazon Prime are guaranteed to be in the condition described." Okay, so look at the word "shipped." Usually, if you say "he shipped a package," usually "shipped" is a verb, okay? This time, though, it's describing the books. Which books? We can't say all of the books in the world, right? Or we can't just say all of the books are guaranteed to be in the condition described because we don't know which books we're talking about. So we have to have this participial phrase in here that says "shipped by Amazon." Again, it's a participle because this is usually a verb, but now it's an adjective to tell us which books. It's describing the word "books," okay? And it is an essential participial phrase because we have to know which books. We can't just say all of the books are in the condition described. It is essential and therefore does not receive commas, okay? So all of the books shipped by Amazon Prime are guaranteed to be in the condition described, okay? The second sentence, "The Kindle e-reader marketed by Amazon is the most popular e-reader available," okay? So here, the Kindle e-reader, we already know which e-reader is being spoken of. We don't need anyone to clarify which e-reader. Okay, like up here, we did need someone to clarify which books were being spoken of. Here we don't. So whenever we say marketed by Amazon, that's just extra information. It is non-essential, and that is why it has commas on both sides. I'm going to show you guys one more thing before you can take the quiz, okay? Okay, so in the last two examples, marketed by Amazon and shipped by Amazon Prime, the words "marketed" and "shipped" are both past tense verbs being used as adjectives, okay? The participles. Okay, so sometimes you can have a present tense verb that's being used as a participle. It's still defining the noun, it's still an adjective, but instead of being past tense, it's present tense. So let me show you a couple of those. This one says, "The man swimming toward the shore became fatigued." Okay, so here, swimming, which man? The swimming man. Okay, so here swimming is an adjective. Which man? The man swimming toward the shore. Okay, so this swimming is usually a present tense verb, but here it's actually a participle. Okay, or you can say swimming toward the shore, Howard became fatigued. Now here, we know which man we're talking about. We've given him a name, Howard. So whenever you say swimming toward the shore, that is actually non-essential because we don't need this to tell us which man, okay? We could just say Howard became fatigued. So swimming toward the shore here is non-essential and does receive a comma. This one here, you wouldn't just say the man became fatigued. We would need to know which man you're talking about. The man swimming toward the shore. So in this one, it is essential and does not receive commas, okay? I hope all that makes sense for you guys. There's just one section in this quiz. If you have any questions, just leave feedback for me on the quiz or email me or whatever you want to do, okay? I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.